Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, 9th September, we'll talk about Joseph, husband of Mary. The lovely story which is recorded in the Gospels begins and ends with the ministry of a Joseph. Did you ever notice that? Joseph of Nazareth at the beginning is a Galilean, a poor man and a carpenter. Joseph of Arimathea at the end is a Judean, a rich man and a counselor. He took the care of the dead body of Jesus Christ. Each was in the right place at the right time and the right condition to be used by God. Joseph the carpenter is never mentioned by Mark and only fleetingly by John. All that we know of him is given to us by Matthew and Luke. In his first two chapters, Matthew records five dreams and four of these are Joseph's. He appears to have been a quiet, meditative, patient man, and Matthew notably says that he was a just man. Joseph is first introduced to us as the betrothed of Mary. When Mary, still virgin, is found to be with child, this just man is minded to end their betrothal. But his kindly disposition wanted him to do it quietly, so that he can cause as little hurt as possible to his young wife. A dream assures him, this conception is miraculous, it is of God. Mary is to be the virgin mother of the Messiah. This must have demanded courage of Joseph. Like as with Mary, there would be much misunderstandings and people would be talking about them. But Joseph accepts his role with quiet dignity. He eventually brings Mary to Bethlehem for registration of their names. The town and the inn were crowded, but the baby is safely delivered and is wrapped up in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger as Joseph stands by, ever faithful but characteristically quiet. In a dream, he is commanded to take the young child and his mother to the safety of Egypt and from the wicked intent of Herod. It is again a dream which directs him to return. He is, however, afraid of Herod's son now reigning, and yet another dream guides him to Galilee and to Nazareth. So did our blessed Lord, born in Bethlehem of Judea, become known as Jesus of Nazareth. After that well-known visit to Jerusalem, when the parents lost the boy Jesus for 3 days, there is no further reference of Joseph's life or ministry. It is assumed that he died during the early years of our Lord's life, but he has left a testimony of a good and righteous man who fulfilled the brief and quiet ministry which God had for him. Though Joseph played an important role of fathering Jesus Christ when he was a child and taking care of Mary, we do not observe him saying a single word also, no utterances at all. He is obedient and filled with humility. We see him as a silent sufferer, taking care of his wife and baby and taking all the risks that were required while traveling to Egypt and then back to Galilee and Nazareth and all these places. They were poor, but still God provided everything to them. It is the belief they have. It is the since he is a just man and he had the fear of the Lord in him, everything went according to God's will. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for teaching us about Joseph today. Yes, Lord, please help us to be obedient and quiet like Joseph. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen. God bless you.